3-point charges are arranged at the points of right triangle. Imagine them on x, y axis. So this is x axis, this is y axis. Q2 is 6 nanocoulombs, and it's here at the origin. Here you have 0.03 meters is Q1, 3 nanometers, 3 nanocoulombs, and here is one of 25 nanocoulombs. Find the net electric force of Q3. It seems easy enough, but there is some complications. So first of all, what is the net force? They are all positive electric charges, so this charge will exert electric force on this charge in straight to the right, and this electric force, this charge will exert electric force downwards, so the downwards, not straightly downwards, but at some angle here. What is that angle? We could calculate using trigonometry, which we will do, but later. So you have two forces. One is F23, that is force exerted on third charge by a second charge, and you have force F13 exerted by force by charge one on the third charge, and you need to add those two forces, these two forces, to get that resulting force Fr here. And now, as you can see, Fr is directed somewhere downwards below the x-axis, but that is not the point. You don't need to find that angle. You just need to find the magnitude and the force, that is the vector's shape of the that force, doesn't matter. So we will, that is a vector sum of those two, these two forces, F13 and F24. As you can see, I first calculated the F23 force, and there is no y component of that force because they are both those electric charges lays on the x-axis. So F23 is just, we just use this Coulomb equation. This is the Coulomb constant, this is the 1x, this is second electric charge, this is third electric charge, and this is the distance between them in meters. So we just calculated the x component to be 843.75 newtons, and y component of that F23 force is zero. Now we find the magnitude. First we need to find the magnitude. Next thing is to find the magnitude of the force F13. Magnitude, not. And magnitude will be, as you can see from this equation and any other, so magnitudes of the charges times Coulomb constant divided by the square distance. Distance from here to here is 0.05 meters. Why? Because this is 0.03 meters, this is 0.04 meters, and when you use Pythagoras' theorem, you will find distance from here to be from here to here to be 0.05 meters. That doesn't matter. Here is the magnitude of that force. This is the Coulomb constant, this is the one one electric charge. This is the second electric charge, and this is the square of the distance. And I've calculated that is to be 270 newtons. Now you get the magnitude of this force, so to speak, length from here to here. But you now need to find x and y components of the force F13 and add that component with these two to find the resulting force and so on. There is complete solution, so you could do it yourself, or for complete written answer, please follow the link in the description. If you want more of this, please subscribe and tell your friends. Thank you. Bye.